Now, let me talk about what I decided to do about these mismatched cylinder heads. I have a whole nother 350 in this garage that I've had sitting around for a couple years now. It's all apart, all cleaned up. So I have two 193 heads off of that engine that are already all apart and all cleaned up. So we're going to use those on the engine we're rebuilding. I looked into other head options, especially Vortex, but it's kind of just too much of a rabbit hole for me to go down, and it's a little too much for this build for now. So we're going to stick with swirl port heads. Yeah, I know that's disappointing to a lot of people, but this is what's going to happen. Now let's talk valve springs. These are the valves from the set of 193 heads we're going to use. This was the GM Goodwrench crate engine with only maybe 20,000 miles on it. So these valve springs should be in very good shape. I want to use these or the new Z28 springs. We'll also compare it to the springs out of these heads, which I know have a lot more miles on them. But how are we going to compare these springs? I have a solution for that. This, my friends, is going to be our valve spring tester. Looks pretty simple? It is pretty simple. Wood. Bolt. Bathroom scale. So again, we have a digital bathroom scale. We have this leverage piece bolted to the pivot, which is clamped in the vise. So the whole idea is to see how much weight one of these springs is putting out at a given height. The installed height we're going to be checking our springs at is going to be 1.710 inches. So the whole idea is that this bolt is going to bottom out once this spring is down to that installed height. So all I'm going to do is press down on the end of the lever, and the bathroom scale should read a pretty good approximation of the strength of this spring. First up, let's try the oldest springs. So I'll be doing my best to just get this bolt to touch the surface without putting any pressure on it. But this isn't exactly a laboratory experiment, so there's only so much you can do. The scale is zeroed out to the weight of this board and the spring resting on it. Okay, so that's the high mileage spring. Now, let's try the low mileage spring. Okay, so that's the lower mileage stock spring. Now let's try the new Z28 springs. It's clear that the Z28 springs are the strongest of the three, and that's exactly what they were sold as and originally used for. A stock style spring that's just a bit stronger. Now what we'll do is run that same test 5 times on each type of spring, and then we'll see what those numbers look like. Now I want to try to set up this test to measure open valve spring tension. So we'll measure the valve springs at 1.210 inches. This is the stock low mileage valve spring number one. Okay, now let's try the Z28 valve springs. I'll have to try real hard not to kill myself doing this. That is interesting because that's vastly different from the manufacturer's spec for these springs. So it's possible I'm doing something a little screwy here, but the results are pretty consistent. I don't believe this is supposed to be measured with any retainers or anything on the springs. Also, the low mileage stock springs check out pretty much exactly. So I'm guessing the Z28 springs are just not as strong as advertised. Also, since these are brand new, this is probably the only compression they've ever had. So the numbers are only going to drop from there. These aren't even broken in. I'm going to go ahead and show those numbers on the screen. Most likely, I'm going to end up using the stock low mileage springs. For one thing, the heads and cam are going to make their power lower down, so they don't really need a whole lot of high RPM valve support anyway. While this scale is here, here's a 193 cylinder head with nothing in it, 41.4 pounds. With the valve train, 45.6 pounds. Crankshaft, 52.8 pounds. I suspect this scale might not like these low numbers. So this is me holding the crankshaft this is me. 183.8. Interesting. I would like to weigh the block, but I'm not going to do that one on my own.